Very often, you will have to make several invoices for one estimate. In that case, it would be very good if you could turn on the Progress Invoicing feature in QuickBooks. Progress Invoicing gives you the ability to make an invoice based on a percent complete, not only from the items completed. It also gives you reports that show the percent complete after each invoice. You switch on this feature in the Preferences window. Let's take a look at the file before you switch on the preference, and then let's take a look at the file after you turn on Progress Invoicing. From the main menu, click Edit, Preferences. When the Preferences window opens up, click Jobs and Estimates, then click Company Preferences. Do you create estimates? This feature was turned on in a previous video. Do you use Progress Invoicing? The answer is yes. Now, after we click OK, when we come back to the Reports main menu and go down for Jobs, Time, and Mileage, we see there's another report added to this list, Job Progress Invoice Versus Estimates. Let's open it up and push A for All. The Job Progress Invoice Versus Estimate report shows the estimates percent complete compared to the invoices of those estimates. But you may well ask, why does the Hanson Place estimate show 0% complete? We know we made invoices for Hanson Place. Well, that's because the Progress Invoicing was not turned on at the moment we made those invoices. Unfortunately, you would have to delete those invoices and re-enter them after you turned on the Progress Invoicing feature. Then you would see the percent complete. Let's go ahead and pin this report up in the icon bar. At the moment the report is the active window, from the main menu click View, Add Job Progress Invoice Versus Estimate to the icon bar. Click OK and here it is. Now we have a shortcut to this report. Now let's look at our first example. Imagine on January 9, we made invoice number 3 for the Mockingbird Lane job under Brown Company. Now, we're billing Brown for 20% of the job complete. So instead of listing each completed item, like we did in the previous video, we will tell QuickBooks that the job is 20% complete. Well, how do we do that? Let's take a look. We open up the invoice window, and we just put in the information. The invoice was dated January 9 of 2017. It was invoice number 3. It was for the Mockingbird Lane job from Hanson Place. Notice it still selects the estimate that's associated with Mockingbird Lane for the Brown job. When we click here and then click OK, aha, this window opens up that was not present before we switched on the Progress Invoicing feature. It's asking us, should we create an invoice for 100% of the job? Or should we create an invoice for a percentage of the entire estimate? This third choice down here we already did in the previous video. So we will not do selected items right now. Right now, let's just put here a percent, and the instructions said that on January 9th, we billed the client for 20% of the entire Mockingbird Lane estimate. Now, look what happens when I click OK. Aha! The quantity of each item is 5. Why is the quantity of each item 5? Because originally on the estimate, the quantity of each item was 25. And we told QuickBooks that we finished 20%. So QuickBooks takes that percent and multiplies it item by item to adjust the quantity to put on the invoice. If we agree with everything, we click Save and Close. And now when we open up the Job Progress Invoice Versus Estimate, aha, look at that. The Mockingbird Lane estimate is now 20% complete. Let's continue in our little story with example two. Let's imagine on January 14th, we made invoice number 4 for the Mockingbird Lane job under Brown Company. And on invoice number 4, we tell QuickBooks that we did an additional 40% more on this invoice for the Mockingbird Lane job. We open up the invoice window from the icon bar. Again, we have to move the date forward. This is January 14th of 2017. Select the same job, Mockingbird Lane. Select the same estimate. Now it's asking us the same question, and again, it's a percent of the estimate, and we're going to put 40%. Now look what happens when we click OK. Aha! QuickBooks puts the quantity of 10, because 10 is 40% of the original 25 quantity for each item. So it puts 10%, it's 40% more progress made. Before we save it, let's make sure to make the date January 14th of 2017. Click Save and Close. Now when we open up the Job Progress Invoice versus Estimate, notice for the Mockingbird Lane job, it now says 60% complete. That's because the previous invoice finished 20% of the job, and this recent invoice finished another 40%, and that's why this report is showing the job is 60% complete. Now it's very important to finish our little story with example 3. On January 17th, we made invoice number 4 again for the Mockingbird Lane job under Brown Company. However, this time we're not going to tell QuickBooks what percent we completed up until January 17th. This time we're just going to tell QuickBooks how many units of each service has been performed since the last invoice. And let's see if QuickBooks can figure out what percent it is and calculate the overall percent complete. Let's take a look. We open up the invoice window again. We move the date forward to January 17th of 2017. We choose that Mockingbird Lane job. We choose the same estimate we've been working with, but this time we're going to click Select Items and click OK. Now QuickBooks gives us the individual items. So I have to click Show Quantity and Rate in order to adjust it by quantity. What it's showing you here is what the estimated quantity is, what the estimated rate is. These are all the information that they got from the estimate. But notice this. This is telling you the prior quantity. In other words, it's telling you the quantity that was actually used. Now, what we have to do here is put in the quantity that we actually earned of each item since the last invoice. So this would be the column to put in the additional items that we did of service or product since the last invoice. Now, we could click Show Percent. Of course, remember, you might have to make your window a little wider. If it doesn't open wider, you might have to adjust your column width if you want to see the information in every column in this Specify Invoice Amounts for Items on Estimate window. Okay, but this is the way you would do it. Now, when you click OK, notice it puts the quantity of 5, which I happen to know is another 20% of the original total estimate. So when we click Save and Close, can you guess what percent of completion this estimate is at? Well, let's open up the Job Progress Invoice versus Estimate report. Aha, now it's 80% complete. Because those additional five items for each item listed was an additional 20% since the last time we billed the customer. And that means the percent complete is now 80%.